Syngin's mom wants him to divorce Tania and come back to South Africa. Guys, what is up? Happy Friday. Hope you guys have an amazing Friday. 90 Day Fiance released a 30-minute sneak peek of the upcoming episode of 90 Day Fiance Happily Ever After. And in this sneak peek, surprisingly, we got to see some pretty good stuff. Now, I'll get into everything in a couple of minutes, but first, we need to talk about how Syngin's entire family, mainly his mom, really is against his marriage with Tania. Now, I never really actually kind of knew what was going on when Syngin was getting married to Tania. I mean, for those of you guys that do remember their, you know, a season or two ago when they actually got married, a lot of stuff went down. They were constantly fighting, but I don't really remember Syngin ever telling his mom or his family any of this, you know, the fighting and whatnot. Because in this little sneak peek of 90 Day Fiance, Syngin's mom pretty much just said, "Hey, I knew that they had minor issues, but I did not realize it was this bad." And she pretty much just said she would think Syngin would be better coming back to South Africa and ending his marriage, because if he's just trying to make it work with Tania and it's never really going to ever work, he's just ruining his journey, in her words. So yes, Syngin's mom wants him to divorce her and come back to South Africa. And the brother pretty much said the exact same thing. The brother just said, "You know, don't you think you would be better off just coming back to South Africa? Everyone you know, everything you know is over here." And Syngin honestly completely agreed. He just went on and said, "You're right, you're right, you're right, but pretty much, because of Tania, he wants to try to give this a shot." He is way, way, way too nice. Let me just say that. I mean, I think everyone, like Syngin's mom, and then Syngin's sister too, she even made a comment like, "I knew that their relationship was just kind of okay, but she was like, after I really saw them together in South Africa, I don't think Tania is as good as I thought she was." So now I think everyone, like his mom, and the sister, and the brother, and even the stepdad, are starting to kind of think, they really aren't a good couple. Syngin is clearly homesick. Why are you still with her? So Syngin's mom is over it. She is done, and she wants him to come back. And she doesn't seem like she's dramatic one bit. She seems honest. She seems real. She just seems like she's, you know, not gonna beat around the bush. This is how she's thinking, and that is how she is thinking. She's over it. She realizes their relationship isn't going to work. So Syngin, why waste your time? Just come back to South Africa. And y'all already know, I hate to kind of gang up on Tania, but I agree with her 100%. Tania and Syngin, they are not whatsoever a good couple. I have heard plenty of rumors they are still together. I've even heard rumors that they are not together, so I don't know what to believe. The only thing I can pretty much believe is a handful of people have seen Tania and Syngin out and about in Connecticut, and I have heard, not for sure, but I have heard that they were really going at it back and forth. So it doesn't sound like their relationship and their marriage has gotten any bit better, but it does seem that he is still in America. So what will happen to Tania and Syngin? I can only imagine the worst, but hey, you guys, I mean, comment below your thoughts on what you guys think. I don't think they're going to be staying together, but hey, like always, I could be wrong. And really quick before I talk about the other couples and what else went down on this little sneak peek, I must say on Sunday, I believe I'm going to be posting a Q&A video. I did one like 6 months ago. I know we have a lot of new subscribers, a lot of new Celeb Talk guy subscribers, and I just want to, I don't know, kind of fill you guys in more on who I am personally, this, that, and the other, where I'm at, what I'm doing, all that kind of personal stuff. So if you want to ask any personal questions or even just reality TV questions, I'm open. But if you guys have any questions about me or my relationship status or anything you guys want to know, I'm happy to answer it. And I'm going to be doing, I believe on Sunday, a Q&A video. So if you have any questions, put in the comments below, and I will definitely, definitely, definitely try to go through and answer them all. But anyway, back onto the rest of this recap. Oh, the first 9 minutes, let me just get this out of the way. The first 9 minutes of this sneak peek was seriously Eric and Larissa, and it was Larissa going to get a checkup for her procedure and her procedures. And honestly, I'm not gonna lie, it looked disgusting. Now, I am not big into medical stuff, and she had, you know, stuff here and stuff here, and you could see a lot. It was, yeah, not very pretty, but this plastic surgeon guy just said, "Oh my God." He goes, "This looks unbelievable." He goes, "She's making great progress. Keep in mind, it's only been 24 hours, but he said she's making great progress, you know, nothing looks bad. He goes, Eric must be taking great care of her. And Eric, I mean, I don't know what I even want to say, to be honest, because this is what happened. Before they went to the plastic surgeon, Eric was literally spoon-feeding Larissa, like yogurt. So I just can't really figure out what is going on. Now, obviously, if you can't tell, I've never had my nose done, and I've never had these done. So maybe someone that has can, you know, kind of shed some light in the comments, because Larissa is acting like she cannot even walk or feed herself. So she's just laying there like this. She can't even stand up. Eric has to literally pick her up and help her walk around. She can't even talk, keep in mind. And so she's just kind of mumbling little words. And I'm watching this thinking, is this for real? Like, I don't think this is scripted. I almost kind of think, and I could be totally wrong, so I don't want to sound really rude or anything, but it's almost kind of like, is it possible that Larissa is just faking, not the pain, but that she's just kind of faking some of this stuff, and Eric is really faking the, you know, the drama and the suspense just for the show and just so they would get some more airtime? Because, I mean, like I said, she got a thing here and she got a thing here done. Why can't her legs work? Now, I don't know, maybe something happened to her legs too, but like, why can't she walk? That's why I just can't figure this out. So maybe it's the, I don't know, the meds, or I don't know why. I could be totally wrong, and I might sound really rude when I say this, but it's almost like she is kind of somewhat sort of faking it. And the doctor did say, I'm sure it's probably pretty painful and whatnot. So, you know, maybe I'm wrong. Maybe I sound rude. I just don't understand why her legs and mouth don't work. Like, Eric literally sat there while she was in bed with her mouth half opened, and he spoon fed her yogurt. So it just seemed kind of dramatic. It once again just reminded me of a soap opera, but maybe I'm being wrong. So put in the comments below what you guys think, but it seemed a little dramatic for me. And then after he spoon fed her yogurt, he ended up having to, like I said, take her to her 24-hour checkup. And at this checkup, Larissa was sitting there pretty much just, you know, not talking. She definitely didn't seem to be very comfortable. And hey, she just had the procedure. I totally get it. But Eric sat there with tears rolling down his face. I mean, you guys, you have to watch this. If you have the TLC Go app, seriously, go check it out, because I can't even explain to you guys how hilarious this was. And I know a lot of you guys are probably gonna troll and comment and say, you're so rude and mean, but I'm telling you guys, it was so funny, because there's no way these tears were real. Like, what is he crying about? She volunteered to have a procedure done. Two procedures. It wasn't some serious life for, you know, life thing where she had to do it. It was like she volunteered to do it. The plastic surgeon said the procedures went amazingly well. What is he crying about? So seriously, you guys, check that out, because for me, I thought it was absolutely hilarious. And I know everyone's probably gonna call me super rude, but anyway, I thought it was funny. And then, you know, Eric made another comment that I can't help but also think is hilarious. And Eric was kind of talking about his relationship with Larissa, which to me, it reminds me of almost like a brother-sister relationship. They don't have some romantic side. They don't seem to have any romantic chemistry at all. He was like, oh my God, for Larissa to trust me to take care of her and for me to take care of her, our relationship has just gotten so strong. And when he said that, I was thinking, okay, Eric, she isn't trusting you. You are the literal last friend that she has that could take care of her, probably for free. So he's acting like Larissa's doing him some huge favor by letting him take care of her. But it's like, Eric, you are taking care of her. She should be paying you. You're doing everything. So it was just comical. It was hilarious. And for those of you guys that are wondering, yes, they are surprisingly still together, because yesterday it was all over social media that Eric sold his house. Now, I don't know if it was actually the house that he posted on the Facebook Marketplace, because if you don't remember, the house that Eric and Larissa were living on in the show, Eric actually posted it for sale in Facebook Marketplace and said in the description that this house was featured on 90 Day Fiance. And it appears that he actually did sell the house yesterday. And now they are moving to Colorado Springs, which I have never, ever, ever been to. It looks beautiful. I think he's from that area, so it kind of makes sense. But anyway, yeah, Larissa and Eric, we wasted like the first 9 minutes of this, you know, 30-minute sneak peek watching them, and really not a whole lot happened. It just seemed like fake drama. Then we saw Angela and Michael, and I mean, I hate to be dramatic and try to make jokes, but it was actually a really sad, you know, thing. Y'all already know, I don't like Angela, not a fan. I feel really bad for Michael. I think Michael is just in a god-awful situation, not gonna lie, but they got married the night before, and then all of a sudden, Angela's daughter called her, you know, at night and said, hey, you know, my grandma, Angela's mom, she was really out of it. She didn't know what was going on, so they had to call 911, they had to get an ambulance, and then she was in the ICU. And now, you know, spoiler alert, I feel like everyone kind of knows now, but in February, Angela's mom did pass away. So I don't know the exact dates. I don't know when Angela got married. I want to say it was like January 25th-ish. And I think her mom did pass away like the first week of February. So, I mean, you know, hey, fingers crossed that she does get to see her mom before she passed away. It's really honestly sad. Like I always say, not a fan of Angela, but I do feel bad for her. I hope her and her mom can at least see each other, even though her mom is clearly out of it and doesn't know what's going on. But it'd be nice if Angela could at least see her mom before she passes on. So, kind of a touchy subject. I feel bad for her. Not a fan of Angela and all her drama, but of course, she's a human being, so I do want to, you know, push my good vibes and everything towards her. I do feel for her. So she had to jump on the quickest flight and get back over to Georgia, and that's exactly what she did. She left Michael, and now when I'm kind of piecing it together with all the craziness going on in the world, I don't think she has seen Michael since she left them. And then we saw just the... It was pretty funny. I'm not going to lie to you guys. We saw Kalani and Asuelu, and if you don't remember, in the last episode, Asuelu's mom finally, she matured. She just became like a normal human being, and she apologized to Kalani for just begging for money and for being rude. So hey, you know, great. That was amazing for her to do that. I am liking her a little bit more. I was never a huge fan of Asuelu's mom, but now I'm starting to kind of like her a little more. But we have to also mention that Asuelu's half-sister, Tammy, she refused to apologize, and she still said that she is still mad at Kalani. Well, guess what? She appears to still be mad, because what happened on the last episode was Kalani and Asuelu went to go say bye to Asuelu's mom and his two sisters, and they went up there, and Asuelu's mom was there. They were all huggy. They were saying bye. It was all fine. His other sister, I think her name was Rose, she was there too. They were, you know, having a good time. But then everyone was saying, where is Tammy? What happened to Tammy? And Tammy is, you know, Asuelu's sister that she just does not like Kalani at all. Well, Asuelu's mom said that Tammy ended up taking an earlier flight, so she left and she never even said goodbye. Now, I think she's horrible. I think she is really... I don't want to use disgusting person because I don't know Tammy. Maybe in real life, maybe the whole thing's scripted. Let me just say, I really, really, really don't think this is scripted. I honestly don't think it's scripted at all. But maybe it is. Who knows? You really don't know. But I feel like Tammy is just jealous and rude, and I think she is just so stuck in her ways, and I think it is real. But maybe I'm gullible and naive, and just maybe the whole show is fake. So I don't know. But yeah, Tammy left, and Asuelu was just like, wow. You could tell he was pretty hurt, because it's like, I mean, come on. Say goodbye. We're probably not going to see each other for a very long time, so at least have the decency to say goodbye, or at least call me or something. And she just picked up and left. She took an earlier flight. She said bye to no one. And Asuelu's mom was like, you know, you have to give her time. Your sister does love you, but she's just kind of going through some stuff. Kind of is what she said. And I think Kalani was ecstatic because Kalani did not want to see her. And Asuelu just said, okay, we'll give her some time. You know, no worries, whatever. And that was basically it. Now, we got to see in the preview that it looks like Colt finally has a sit down with his mom, Debbie, and pretty much just says, hey, mom, you need to kind of get out of my life and get out of my business because some stuff with my personal life is a little bit too personal for you to be involved in. And let me just say one thing. If he wants his mom to get out of his personal life, he should do one thing and one thing only. Move. Even just like move across the street. Why do you live with your mom? He always says that he's taking care of his mom. Okay, let's be real, guys. Debbie, she is fully, you know, normal. She has nothing going wrong with her. I mean, she can do stuff on her own. She isn't that old. She's perfectly capable of basically doing anything that she needs to do. So, I mean, that is a bunch of crap that he takes care of her. He could obviously move out. I'm sure they were probably kind of trying to save some money, but now he's got the show. I think he has a job in IT. Now he's doing OnlyFans. He must have enough money to pay for his own rent. So I am so sick and tired of even seeing Colt still live with his mom, but it did look like in the preview that after he told his mom that, hey, you know, I need a little bit of distance, she got really upset. And if Debbie actually gets upset that Colt wants just a little bit of distance in his relationship life, I'm over her, I am done. Then everything that everyone has been saying that Debbie is just out of it is completely 100% true. And for everything else that went down with Andre and Elizabeth's brother Charlie, we did not get to see even a smidge, and I was crossing my fingers, I was hoping, I was sending out my good energy that we were going to see, you know, just, I wanted to see just a little snippet on what actually happens with the two of them, and we don't get to see anything. So I'm sure that will be the main event this Sunday. I am super excited to see how it goes down, so fingers crossed, but we're going to have to wait. Well guys, thank you all so much for watching. Like I said at the beginning of this video, I am doing a Q&A, so if you have any questions for me, am I single? I get that question all the time. Am I single? Would I date an older woman? I get that all the time. Would I date an older woman? Would, I don't know. You know, where am I from? What do I do for work? Anything y'all want to know, really, I'm pretty open. I try to be an open book as much as possible. So if y'all want to know anything about me, or I don't even know, you have any questions, or if you have any reality TV questions too, I am more than happy to spill my beans, tell y'all everything I know. And so I am doing this Q&A on Sunday. So put in the comments below anything you guys want to know, and I will try my best to read every single question within reason. I know I don't want to make the video, you know, like 2 hours long, so I'm gonna try to, you know, hit all the questions I can hit, and hopefully you guys find the Q&A actually kind of entertaining and interesting. So that video should be out on Sunday. Put in the comments below. In the meantime, make sure to hit that like button, comment below, hit that subscribe button, and stay tuned for many more videos. Well, hey guys, I hope you guys have a fantastic Friday, an incredible weekend, and I will be seeing you guys tomorrow.